Good evening to everyone. I'm here to talk about the environment at the same time talking about the science. And as you see nowadays, our own environment, which is the ocean, is already polluted. When you see the ocean, or sea, or any water resources, everything is polluted by something, which is made by a human. And there was I want to introduce one teacher named Cesar Harada. He is a teacher at the same time, he's also a scientist who wants to discover, who wants to protect the ocean. And at the same time, of course, he wants to teach the children how to love science and how to protect our own environment by using science. And as you see, our own ocean already 80% of the ocean is already polluted by the plastic, and also 50%, more than 50% is polluted by the oil, and our ocean really became dirty because of us. And there are many ways that we have to protect our own environment, because without ocean, we cannot live, we cannot survive. But people are always destroying the ocean that we must protect. Like they are destroying, like using plastic and oil spill and radioactive and nuclear power plants, which is very bad to us. If we don't protect this, if we are always putting this in our own ocean because we think the ocean is very large, and if we just throw this few amount of the plastic, it won't affect it. That is how we think. But like, if we throw like these small particles, this can be bigger and bigger, and they can, no, look at this, 80% of our ocean is already polluted. Even though they threw the little by little, but this plastic became bigger and bigger, and this already became our problem in our now generation. And of course, if the ocean is polluted now, we have to worry about the next generation who will be born, and we have to start to protect the ocean for our also next generation. If our ocean just like and it became polluted too much, next generation will not able to clean the ocean also. We have to start a cleaning up and at the same time to love our own environment. And I said Cesar Harada is a scientist and at the same time he's a teacher. And he has a many way for us to clean the ocean. He has some ways for him to clean the ocean. First is that he made the small pom-pom into a workshop, and he was making a tools with using only a wood and not using oil. He just used electric, and at there he borrowed the imagination from the kids who has a wild run imagination, because kids has a very good imagination. And he said, can you please draw something that can help us to protect our ocean? And he just waited for him to draw. What he did is he just picked the best of the drawing and best idea from the kids, and they will discuss with the students, and they will agree to do something. And after that, of course, if someone draw the robot, of course they have to start to making the robot. So they create the robot that can help them to clean the ocean. And but the first thing is that maybe he's thinking of that he's lacking of the information. So what he did is that the robot was putting in the ocean, and if he moves, he can gather the plastic that is inside the ocean. And when they check it, next generation will look at this data, and maybe they can find a way to fix the to clean the ocean, to make the ocean tidy. And this another method was that borrowing the imagination, and he went to another place. Also, you know, Fukushima in Japan, there were big tsunami there, and of course many people died because of the tsunami. And not just that, there's a one place named Fukushima, and there's a nuclear power plant. And I think there's a big tsunami, and it happened, of course. That just got broke down, and it polluted the ocean. And they said the nuclear power plant is even spreading to the Pacific Ocean. And you know, he visited that place, and he wants to know. He wants to help the ocean. He wants to stop the nuclear power plant, and maybe they can have a and for them to protect our own nature, our own environment. That was his second way. He visited there, and of course he discovered what's the problem and how can they help. How can he help the environment? And what I say is that my topic is usually about the cleaning the ocean and how to love science and protecting the ocean using science. And there's only few things that I say, and the major is that we have the lesson that I tell you is that I want you to know that we have to prepare for our own next generation. We have to prepare for next generation. Of course, we cannot think only ourselves. We have to think other people. We have to think of the other babies who haven't seen the ocean. Like when you grow up and you have a baby and the ocean is polluted, and that's why we are not allowed to go inside the ocean. And maybe your son will ask, why am I not allowed to go inside? What you can tell is that just a lie. Because it's dangerous. Because it's dirty enough. When you're not going to talk about we are the one before generation was the one who dirty the ocean. They're not going to talk about this one. And so we have to prepare, starting now, for not for us, but for the next generation that will be born and that will protect the environment. The people will protect the environment. And he said, I don't want you to lie to your own child. I don't want you to tell the lie to the younger people, to the younger generation. You have to tell the fact. Like what he did, he borrowed the imagination from the children, and he let them draw the way for them to protect the environment. We have to do this. We have to do the same things like what he did. We also need to borrow imagination from other people, which is came from younger generation, because their minds run wild, and we need their imagination for us to clean our own mess. And the old speech that I say, it's about the clean ocean, and we really need to clean our ocean. Because our ocean is already dirty, and without nature, Margaret Mead said, we don't have society if we destroy the environment, which means no environment, no ocean, no resources, no more extinction. Thank you.